Hey everybody, and welcome back to It's Only Food with Chef John Politte. Today we are going to be making liver and onions. Cue the music. Thanks a lot for watching today. I appreciate you joining us from whatever platform you are watching us on. Don't forget to like, subscribe, leave a comment down below, and then share this channel and this video with everybody you know. All right, like I said, we're gonna be making liver and onions, so let's drop down here and see what we've got for our ingredients. We've got 2 tablespoons of vegetable oil, 2 yellow onions that we have julienned, 1 cup of all-purpose flour, 1/4 teaspoon of salt, 1/4 teaspoon of black pepper, 2 6-ounce skinned and deveined beef liver slices, and then I got another 2 tablespoons of vegetable oil that we're gonna use when we cook the liver. Let's bread this up and then we'll head over to the stove. All right, you wanna get your flour, of course, seasoned with the salt and pepper. And then when it comes to the liver, you wanna make sure that the liver is actually thawed out more than this. You want it to be, well, it's pliable, but you want the flour to adhere to everything and stay. And it's usually if the liver is thawed out enough to where it's really bloody, that's the best time to do this. I'm gonna take our seasoned one with the flour on it and just set it off to the side. With this one as well, I'm going to keep the flour just in case. Now, you can marinate the raw liver in milk. It takes away some of the flavor that you might not like. It helps to tenderize it a lot. I have made this the way we're doing it right now, by breading it and frying it up in oil. I have baked it on sheet trays with no flour. I have baked it in sheet trays with flour and little oil. I've made this a lot of different ways, and the best way, I think, when I eat it, because I like to eat liver too, is this way here, because it's the most tender and it's not tough and chewy. So, all right, let's head over to the stove. All right, there's our mise en place, our onions all sliced up, ready to go. Got our breaded liver, a little bit extra flour just in case. And we got 4 tablespoons of oil, 2 tablespoons are for the onions, 2 tablespoons are for the liver. Let's focus on our pan. Oh, and I've got our utensils back here as well. Let's focus on the pan, start cooking. All right, we've got a hot pan going here. I'm gonna go ahead and put our half of this oil in. It's gonna be for our onions. All right, we got pan's hot, oil is hot, here we go. Drop the onions right on in. Now, when it comes to slicing your onions, it doesn't matter if you want to slice them like you would for a burger. What I'm showing you right here in this video card is how to slice them that way. And or if you want to just julienne them, it doesn't matter, because once these are cooked down and caramelized the way you want them to be, they're going to be kind of, there's going to be no structure left to them. So they're going to be, you'll see what I'm talking about when we get to that point, because I'll bring it up again. But just slice them, doesn't matter how you slice them, they're going to end up the same way. We're going to let these cook down and then we'll go from there. Yep, got some color on them now. I'm gonna hit them with a little salt and pepper. Let these keep cooking down. Okay, I'm just gonna flip these over a little bit. Yeah, they're starting to cook. Trying to get, don't wanna rush it. High heat, stir often. Let them just cook. You want them to get broken down, caramelized. Take some time though, do it right. All right. They are cooked down kind of to where I want them for right now. Now I'm going to take the onions out of here and we'll start cooking our liver. So let's take your onions, throw them on a plate, bowl, whatever you want. Pan is still warm. A little bit of onions are still in there. Not a big deal. I'm going to add the rest of our liver. I'm going to glove up, because I'm handling the liver and the flour again, and equipment from a camera. So, medium high heat. You got your oil in there. You got your onions fragrancing. I'm gonna hit it one more time with the flour. Get a nice coat on there. Just set it right on in. Remember, if your liver is frozen, you don't wanna put it into the hot oil. You want to be careful that you're not getting spitting back at you, because that frozen liver will
ice crystals or something might come out and hit that hot oil and might splatter on you. So just be careful. We're gonna let this cook on this side. We start seeing blood coming through there. All right, we got some coagulated blood coming through. So I'm gonna go ahead and flip it right back over on the side into the oil. And we'll just let do the same thing on this side. A lot of variables you can do. You can cook it with butter if you want to. Just remember, butter doesn't have a high tolerance for high heat. So it might burn or evaporate out on you before you get, you know, everything cooked. I know, you know, a lot of people don't like liver and onions. So, you know, if you're here and you're watching, I hope you're learning something and maybe appreciating the dish a little bit more. Leave me a note in the comments. Let me know what's going on, you know. And if you don't like it, just let me know why. I mean, I love it, it's good. This is a thicker cut too, but I like fresh liver, of course, from deer. That's always the best. If you do it right, it'll do it, you know, if you make it right, it's good. Some people might have been turned off on it when they were younger, when they got it served to them because it was, you know, not done right or something, or it was tough. But I'll guarantee you, you do it this way with the flour on there, heat it at a high temp, and, you know, lock in and seal those, that moisture inside there. All right, we flipped it over again, and we're gonna have more blood coming out this way too. But I wanna show you what I do to finish this off. You just put your onions right back in there. Spread them all over. Turn your heat off, throw a lid on it. In 10 minutes, I'll be ready to eat. So when it is done, we're gonna plate it up. We're gonna make it look pretty. We're gonna take a ton of photos, put those photos in the timeline with some really good music. Then we're gonna come back and give it a taste. So stay tuned, enjoy the music. The liver show. Hope you enjoyed the music. Those pictures are pretty nice. I'm gonna turn this over. I'll just come over here. I'm gonna cut this using a table knife, not using a steak knife. Got a nice piece of liver right there. Cooked just right, medium. No blood really coming out of it. Right there. Yeah, that's just awesome. Yeah, this is really good. Good and moist, tender, got some flavor to it. There you go. One more shot. Oh. Very simple and easy recipe, not that hard. Recipe is down in the description box for the first pinned comment. Print it off, keep it, you'll make this. If you don't like liver, just because you think you got it made wrong when you were a kid or whatever, make it this time, try it out, you never know. But this is really good. Glad you watched. I know it's liver and onions, not everybody's favorite, but we had to do it. You know we did. Liver and onions, it's good for you. I got an extra piece of liver over there too if anybody wants it. Let me know. Take care. Rappers don't listen, but let me show them something. You hear that beat bumping from the soul kitchen. Now what you fixing up? Good food, soul food, come and pick it up. These rappers don't listen, but let me show them something. You hear that beat bumping from the soul kitchen. Yeah, now what you fixing?